Hello and welcome to the 28th video in this beginner's guide to Adobe After Effects. In this tutorial, we are going to look at how we can export our projects from After Effects. So now we are coming to the end of the essential practice section on this course. Once we have finished our animated sequences and built our video presentations, it's time to export them. Now, there are a few ways to export in After Effects, but there is only one you should really consider using. In this video, I'll be demonstrating how you can export your finished projects off in After Effects. So in this video, we will be covering the following topics: the export checklist, exporting using the media encoder, exporting using the render queue, and exporting the work area. After this video, you will get a better understanding of how to export your projects in After Effects. So let's get into it. So here I am in After Effects, and I have a project open here that I'm going to use to demonstrate how to export in After Effects. What I have here is a number of video sequences we have created over the past few videos. So let's have a go at exporting some of these compositions. Now, if you have the project folder, you can open up this document I have here. With the project folder open, click into the S2 Essential Practice folder, into folder 28, Exporting, and open the Exporting After Effects file. And you'll have the same document I have open here. This is a document you can use to quickly experiment with exporting with me in this video. Now, if you don't have the project folder and you want to follow along with this tutorial using this document I have prepared especially for you, you can download this project folder for a small fee. The download link with instructions are in the description. The download folder comes with lots of exercise documents we will be using on this course that have been carefully developed to aid your learning experience. The folder also comes with document resources such as videos, graphics, and images you can use to build your first video presentation from scratch later on in this course. To get the full learning experience, I recommend you get the project folder. Download link with instructions is in the description. So with the project folder open, click into the S2 Essential Practice folder, into folder 28, Exporting, and open the Exporting After Effects file, and you will have the same document I have open here. So now I want to draw your attention over to the project panel. Here you can see I have a folder called Export, and in here I have a number of compositions. These are some of the exercises we undertook over the previous videos, and you can choose any of these to export. For now, I'm going to double click on the first comp, Video Edit. So this is a composition we created earlier in the course when we looked at pre-composing layers. Here we have the intro section, a Hyde Park section, and the aquarium section. So once happy with the sequence, let's export it. But before that, there are a few things we need to check before we export any project out of After Effects. Before we export anything out of After Effects, we first need to check the workspace area and the resolution factor. For example, I want to export this composition, but right now, if we look at the workspace area on the timeline, we can see that it's currently set between the middle section only. Now, if we were to export like this, we would only export this section. The work area on the timeline panel can be used to export specific sections of a composition. Now, we will come back to this a little later, but for now, if we want to export the entire composition, we will need to make sure the work area is across the whole comp. So I could come and drag the edges of the work area and drag them to the far end of each side. Or a cool little tip is to simply double click on the work area to expand it to the full area of the timeline. Perfect. So that's the work area sorted. Now the last thing we need to make sure is that the resolution factor is set to full. Right now, my resolution factor is set to half. I typically use half because I find it a lot smoother previewing on my computer as I develop my project. Now, if you export with the resolution factor at half, you will of course have an exported video with half the quality. So before you export, make sure to set the resolution factor to full. With these two things checked, you are now ready to export. So the first way you can export in After Effects is using Adobe Media Encoder. So when we're ready, come up to Composition, and click Add to Adobe Media Encoder. Upon click, you will see a new app open. So it's important to mention that there was once a time where all rendering was done inside After Effects, but since 2014, it has been advised to render in Adobe Media Encoder. for a few reasons we will come to shortly. But for now, let's see how the media encoder works. Now, if any of you are using After Effects before 2014 and don't have the media encoder, don't worry, I'll be showing you another way shortly. So, with Adobe Media Encoder open, we will see the composition appear in the list. And from there, we can define a few settings. First, we can click on Preset. Upon click, this will give us a list of options we can choose from. So first, we can click Format. Now, from this list, we can choose an array of formats. But in this case, we are going to stay with the popular H.264 format. Now, for those of you not familiar, the H.264 format is good for compressing video, while at the same time retaining good quality. Files exporting using this format produce a video with a .mp4 extension, and are generally quite light and not too large. Easy for sharing online, uploading to social media and YouTube. And this is exactly the format I use to export my videos. So under this, we can choose the preset. Again, we have a list of options here that will change the rendering settings. But I always set mine to match the source for maximum quality. Next, we can choose the output name and destination. If we click this, we can choose where we want to export the video. So I'll navigate to the project folder and into the exports folder. I'll name it to Video Export 1 and click Save. I will make sure we export audio and video, but in this instance, we have no audio. Now, if you have audio and wish not to export it, you could toggle this off here. So below this, we have the summary, which we can look at to make sure everything looks good. And below this, we have a series of tabs, which we don't need to worry too much about at this point. All the settings in here have been set by our format and preset above. Below, we have a couple of checkboxes, but in this instance, I will leave those alone. So once we are happy with the settings, it's now a case of setting the composition to render. To do this, we can hit the play button at the top right of the menu box. Upon click, we will trigger the render and see a render progress bar at the bottom of the panel, along with the output preview. To the right of the review is all the details for the video. Here is another moment where you can look over the settings. Once the video has completed rendering, we will see a tick to the right of the row. So now we can navigate to the export location and notice that the file format is a .mp4. And if I double click on the video file, I can proof for quality. And once happy, I can then share my video and publish it online. Excellent. So that's how you can render a comp using the media encoder. So back into After Effects, remember what I mentioned about the work area. So if we come back to the video edit comp, there may be occasions where you will only want to export a certain amount of your video as a preview. So if, for example, I only wanted to export this last section of the comp, I can do this by setting the work area. So if I click on the timeline to place the time indicator at the start of the third section and press B to set the beginning of the work area, with the work area now set covering just the third section, I'll come up to Composition and click Add to Adobe Media Encoder. Upon click, Media Encoder will open and I'll see the new comp on that list. So if I choose where to export it and hit the render button, After Effects will only render that part of the video out. Easy. So keep in mind, it's important how your workspace is set before rendering a video. Next, I want to show you something quite cool when exporting with the media encoder. So back into After Effects, over in the project panel, this time I will select another composition and I'll go with Wish You Were Here. So with this composition open, I'll make sure that the resolution factor is set to full and the top work area spans the entire comp. I'll come up to Composition and click Add to Adobe Media Encoder. So again, upon click, Media Encoder will appear, and we will see the composition added to the queue. Now before hitting Render, I'll come back into After Effects. This time, I will select the Dreamy comp. I'll make sure that the resolution factor is set to full, and the work area spans the entire comp. I'll come up to Composition and click Add to Adobe Media Encoder. Again, Media Encoder will appear, and we will now see this new composition added to the queue. So now we have two. Now back into After Effects. This time I will select the Old History comp. I'll make sure that the resolution factor is set to full and the work area spans the entire comp. I'll come up to Composition and click Add to Adobe Media Encoder. Again, Media Encoder will appear, and we will now see the new composition added to the queue. So now we have three compositions in the list. So what we can do here is essentially stack a list of compositions we want to export. And you can stack as many as you wish here. So I'll click on the output for location for each comp and navigate to the project folder on my computer. Once happy, I'll come up and click on the render play button in the top right. This will then trigger my three comps to start rendering. Once the first composition is rendered, the next one will start automatically. Now the cool thing about this is that when a video is rendering, you can jump back into After Effects and keep working. You can even open another file and start working on another project. Adobe Media Encoder offers you the flexibility to keep working while rendering in the Media Encoder. Pretty cool. So once the renders are finished, you will see the tick next to the comps. And if we want to remove these from the list, we can simply click them and press delete on the keyboard. So that's how simple it is rendering multiple comps in Media Encoder. Now, there is another way to render in After Effects, though this technique is not used as common as the Media Encoder. As mentioned earlier, the Video Encoder was launched back in 2014. Now, the Media Encoder is used to render really streamlined, compressed video at maximum quality for things like presentations and uploading to YouTube. Before rendering in Media Encoder, we had to render in After Effects. Now, for those of you using previous versions, this is how you will export in After Effects. So back in After Effects, with the comp open, come up to Composition and this time click Add to Render Queue. Upon click, you will see the timeline panel change to the render queue. This will present a bunch of settings we can define before we export our video. So this is similar to the Media Encoder. Here we can change the render settings. If we click this, it's much like we saw in the Media Encoder. For now, I'll just cancel that. And next, we have the output module. If we hit that, a bunch of output settings will appear. Again, this is much like we saw in the Media Encoder. Now, if you're using an older version of After Effects, you should be able to select the H.264 format in this dropdown. However, in newer versions of After Effects, with the Media Encoder, we won't have this option here. In newer options of After Effects, here we can only export as QuickTime, which is going to create a huge file. For newer versions of After Effects, this is why we should really use Media Encoder. But if you're using an older version, select your H.264 format here. For now, I'll click Cancel. So with the rendering and output settings sorted, all that's left is to choose where we want to export the video by clicking on the last setting on the right, Output 2. Upon click, we will get a dialog box asking to name the video and where to save. On this occasion, I'll navigate to the project folder and select the export folder. I'll keep the name and click Save. Now, once you are happy and ready to render, click the Render button on the top right of the Render Queue panel. Now, upon clicking Render, you will now see a progression bar appear along the top of the Render Queue panel, and you will see the video play as it progresses in the composition panel. Now, unlike with the Media Encoder, when we render this way, we cannot keep using After Effects. If you render this way, you will have to wait until it's finished to continue working. Once the render is complete, we will hear the infamous ding sound. And if we navigate to the project folder, we can see our video as a QuickTime video. And if you're using an older version, you should be able to see your .mp4 here. So that is how you can export your project out in After Effects. Now, remember, if like me, you are only going to use After Effects to create videos to share on social media or upload to YouTube, I would strongly recommend you use the Adobe Media Encoder to export nice, streamlined video files. So that's it. We are now done with the second section of the course. Over the past 28 videos, I have covered everything you need to know as a beginner to Adobe After Effects, ready to start your own projects. Now it's time to take all of what we have learned and create a project from scratch. Now, after this last section on the course, you should be able to undertake projects alone and create more work comfortably in After Effects. So see you in the next video.